Hello everybody, welcome to Camtek Institute. Today we're going to discuss some important questions which are related to percentage and fraction. And these questions are often asked in the competitive exams as well as your routine academic classes. So here we start. This is our percentage fraction table. I'm sure you must have watched my previous video. We had discussed in details, but just to refresh you once again, as you know, 1% stands for, if we convert into fraction, 1/100. 5% is 1/20. Similarly, 10%, 20%, then 25%, 50%, 75% is 3/4. So try to remember, and you should know it by heart. This way, you're going to save a lot of time during your competitive exams. Similarly, this is a mixed fraction percentage to fraction conversion table, which we had discussed in our previous video. Just to refresh you once again, like 1/3% stands for 1/3 when we convert into fraction. Then 2/3% is equivalent to 1/6, and this is how it goes about. And till the last, like we have here, 5/19% stands for 1/19. So just refresh yourself and try to remember it, then the things will become very easy for you, right? So we switch over to the problems now, right? So we come to question number one. It says, what number do we get when 25% of 600 is added to 30% of 500? Right? So these two numbers have to be added together. Okay, 25% of 600 plus 30% of 500. Now, if you remember the table we just started, we refreshed ourselves with, if we convert percentage into fraction, 25% stands for 1/4. So 1/4 into 600 plus 30% of 500. Now, 30%, if you all know, is equivalent to 30/100, right? Here, these two zeros get canceled. We get 3/10 into 500. Okay. Now we further divide 4 and 600. We get 150 over here. And here, these two zeros get canceled. And 3 into 50 is 150. So 150 plus 150, 300 is the answer to the question. And that is how we're going to do it. These are simple, right? So we come to question number two over here. It says a population of a city in the year 2019 was 5 lakh. Now it has increased by 75%. So what is the new population? Okay. So the present population of the city is 5 lakh. There's an increase of 75%. Now if we convert this 75% into fraction, we refer to the table, it is equivalent to 3/4. So there has been an increase of 3/4 of the present population. So we'll first find 3/4 of the population, present population, and add it to the original population. So 5 lakh into 3/4 plus the original population. These are to be added and we get the answer. Okay. When we cancel 4 with 5 lakh, we get 1,25,000 multiplied by 3. Okay. Plus 5 lakh. Then we multiply 3 with 1,25,000. We get 3,75,000 plus the original population, which was 5 lakh. And when we add the 2, we get 8,75,000, which is the present population after the increase of 75%. Okay, simple, you got it. In case you not understood, repeat the video once again. Okay, fine. So we come to question number three. It says, if the savings are decreased by 20%, what is the new amount that a person saves if the income is 30,000 and expenses are 20,000? So originally the savings are what? They were income minus the expenses, that is 30,000 minus 20,000 equivalent to 10,000. Now he says that there's a decrease in 20% to the original savings. The original savings were 10,000 and the decrease of 20%. And if we convert into fraction, 20% is equivalent to 1/5. Okay. So 10,000 into 1/5, we get 2,000. So there's a decrease of 2,000 in the original savings. So that means the original savings were 10,000 minus 2,000, that is 20% of the original savings, and we get 8,000 as the answer to the question. Simple. I hope you all got it, right? So we come to question number four. It says the length of a rectangle is 100 meters and the breadth is 50 meters. If the length of the rectangle is increased by 20% and the breadth is decreased by 10%, find the new area of the rectangle. Originally, the length of the triangle, the rectangle is 100 meters, and there's an increase of 20%. So 100 meters and an increase of 20% means, if we convert into fraction, it is 1/5. So when we calculate, it comes to 20 meters. There's an increase of 20 meters in the length of the rectangle. So 100 plus 20, we get 120 meters over here, which is the new length of the rectangle. Similarly, the breadth has decreased by 10%. Originally, the breadth was 50 meters. So 50 into 10% decrease, 10/100 is 1/10. 0, 0 get cancelled, we get 5. So there's a decrease in 5 meters as far as the breadth of the rectangle is concerned. So 50 minus 5, we get 45 meters. Okay, so the new length is 120 meters and the new breadth is 45 meters. Okay. And we know the area of a rectangle, the formula is length into breadth. So 120 into 45, the answer is 5400 meters square. The answer of the question. Okay. So we come to question number 5. It says 500 is a number which is increased by 20%. And then again, it is increased by 20%. So there's an increase of 20% twice in the number. So we have to find the final number. Okay. The number is 500. There's an increase of 20% for the first time, that is 20% is equivalent to 1/5. So 500 into 1/5 is 100. So we add 100 to 500. So the first increase gives 600. Okay. Then again, there's an increase of 20% once again. So 600 is increased by 20% again. So it is 1/5. 600 into 1/5 is 120. So second time, there's an increase again of 120. So 600 plus 120 gives 720. So the final answer is 720. Okay. I hope you all understood, right? So we come to question number 6. It says a man spends 75% of his income, which is 4,000. Okay. And now his income has increased by 20% and his expenses have decreased by 10%. So what are his savings now? Okay. Now his income is 4,000, out of which 75% are the expenses he's incurring right now. So 4,000 into 75% is 3/4 when we convert to fraction. So when we calculate, we get 3,000. So as of now, he is spending 3,000 rupees every month. Okay. Now the expenditure has decreased by 10%. Originally it was 3,000. Now it has decreased by 10%. So 10% of 3,000 is 1/10. That is 300. And when we subtract 300 from 3,000, we get 2,700. So his new expenses is 2,700. Similarly, it says that the income has increased by 20%. It is mentioned over here, 20% increase in the income. Originally, the income of the person is 4,000. Increase of 20% means multiplied by 1/5. So it comes to 800. So there's an increase of 800 in the income of the person. So we add 800 to 4,000, we get 4,800. So the new income is 4,800 and the new expenditure is 2,700. So when we find the difference, we get the savings. 4,800 minus 2,700 is 2,100, which is the answer to the question. I hope you all understood. In case you did not, please repeat the video once again. So we come to question number 7. It says what has to be added? What should be added to 12.5% of 184 so that the sum is equal to 37.5% of 252. I'm sure you remember the table, that the conversion table we had studied earlier, percentage fraction. So what we're going to do, we know 12.5% of 184 is equivalent to 1/8 into 184, since 12.5% is equivalent to 1/8. So 1/8 into 184, we get 23 over here. Once we 8 ones are cancel the 2, we get 23 over here. Okay. Similarly, 37.5% of 252, 37.5% is equivalent to 1/3. Refer to the table once again. And once we divide it by 3, we get 84 over here. This is 84. Okay. So what has to be added to 23 so that it becomes 84? That is what we have been asked. So we'll subtract 84 minus 23, we get 61. So 61 is the answer we're looking for. I hope you all understood. In case you're not, just repeat that video once again. With this, we come to the end of the video. It is quiz time now. Do it yourself. Do these sums and send me your answers in the comment box given below. We also look forward to your feedback. Right? Thank you so much. Bye-bye.